Hello, I'm Dr. Vinay Koparkar, founder Papillon Hair World. I'm a doctor by profession and doing medical practice and treating hair loss patients for more than 30 years. This video is going to be about hair care tips for kids. Honestly, this video is more for the mothers of the kids below 10 years. Always remember, most of the times when the child is 1 month old, 1.5 months old, there is a tradition in our society to put lot of oil into the gap of the skull, which is originally present for 2 to 3 months, and to keep it there for the entire day. Honestly, it is not correct. You should apply sufficient amount of oil, but you should not put 2 ml, 3 ml, 4 ml oil onto the gap in the gap of the scalp with the expectation that it will feel earlier. Nothing of that kind happens. Most important disadvantages of this is I have seen many patients, many children, many infants, many small babies having a tremendous amount of a dandruff, a thick layer, thick slug of a dandruff, giving tremendous problem to the infant. Not only that, because of that slug, if you try to remove them, there is a hair loss also happens when you try to remove that slug. So for God's sake, no excessive oil in a child of the age 1 month, 2 months, 3 months. Second, about the oil application, then what to do and when to apply oil. Oil must be applied only once or two times a week, and that also at bedtime, and that also only to the scalp. Application of oil to the hair has got no role. So always remember, whenever you want to put a ponytail, or when you want to put a plait, or when you want to tie the hair, always remember there is no necessity of application of oil to the hair. In fact, if the child carries oil during the daytime on the hair, always remember there is a chance of getting a dandruff, and also there is a chance of getting lice in their hair because of the tight ponytail and also oil on the hair. So no oil during the daytime. Next, always remember you should not shampoo the hair every day. You must shampoo hair once or two times a week, normally after the application of oil on the previous night. The quantity should be marginally 1 or 2 ml. It should not be more than 5 to 10 drops. It should be so much less quantity. I strongly advise to use baby shampoos or sulfate free shampoos for your children. Third, most important, please don't use any herbal products or any home remedies as a replacement to the shampoo. Don't use shikikai, don't use rita, or don't use chana dal and milk for cleaning the hair. I insist once again, you should use mild shampoos to the hair to remove the oil applied on the previous night. Tying of the hair. First, if you want to put a plait, please don't put lot of oil for the convenience of putting a plait. It is absolutely wrong. And number two, if at all you are putting a plait, please, whenever the child comes from the school bag, please keep the hair open for the remaining time. The same thing applies for putting up the ponytail also. For God's sake, don't pull all the hair back and put the tight ponytail. I do understand that 99% of the schools insist for tying the hair, but that does not mean you should pull it to such an extent that the child will get a traction hair loss and 1 cm or 1.5 cm receding of the line in his future in 9th standard or 10th standard. So for God's sake, try to put a loose ponytail and not a tight ponytail. And third, I have seen many mothers, after putting the tight ponytail, they try to put the hair band or lots of clips by taking all hair upward and backward. Always remember, for a child when the hair is delicate, pulling this hair extraordinarily tight and putting lots of clips or putting the additional hair band definitely damages the hair. So for God's sake, if at all you are wearing a plait, if at all you are putting a ponytail or putting up the clips, remember those should be loose enough. And most important, when the child completed its all events during the daytime, in the evening times or at least in late evenings, you must keep all hair 100% open. No use of any hair care products. Don't use products like serum or conditioners for a child. For God's sake, it is of no use. Next important, up to age 12 or 13, don't take your child to the beauty parlor treatment except the hair cutting. Hair spa treatments are not advisable to the child at all. Next, most important is no home remedies. No home oils to be applied. No aloe vera gel is supposed to be applied. For example, no eggs application to the hair. Last, many times people put curd or lemon when there is a dandruff. For God's sake, no such home remedy should be attempted in a child below 12 years. Remember, no external interferences into the growth of the hair by putting lot of home remedies or artificial products onto the hair. Last, most important, combing of the hair. The most ideal care of the hair during childhood is comb the hair of your child minimum 2 times, 5 minutes each. And I insist that combing should be to do a gentle massage to the scalp and not for removing the tangle. So twice a day combing, minimum 3 to 5 minutes every time, is the most ideal care for your kid.